Hello my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I thought I'd put the video, the camera on to do a little craft with me. I'm working on a small kit, because you know I've done some small journals, and the embellishment kits I normally make are always to fit a full size, like roughly 8x5 or something like that. And so I've been working on some bits and pieces for the smaller journals, because I've got a little journal and I love it. And like, remember when I did the full size one of these, I thought it'd be really nice to have like teeny tiny one that can fit in one of the little pocket sized journals. Well, I say pocket size, they're normally really chunky. But yeah, I've got a couple of index cards. This was a white one that's been sprayed with multiple colours. I might be that way. Yeah. And yeah, this is just a plain. You can buy them really cheaply. Like, sometimes they're called index cards, sometimes they're called revision cards. And you can get them in packs for really, really cheap. I hunt around, it's my little mission to sort of find things and sniff out the bargains, because it can get expensive if you're buying things off of the internet all the time and that, or ordering sort of bits that you can use of ephemera off of people. It can get really expensive, so I'm always on the lookout for little bits and bobs that I think would make good ephemera, and yeah, then zhuzhing it up and doing what I want to do with it. Like this is for drinks, and it's for, I found it in the wedding section in the pound shop, and it's like, yeah, this drink is on us, and so like it's a little ticket, and people must give them out at their weddings so that they can get the first, their guests can have the first drink free. So it says valid for one beverage, but I thought that was really cool. So yeah, I picked them up the other day, and I've got a couple of different packs of index cards. These ones got dots instead of lines, so I thought they made a change. Hang on, it should be that way up, because the biggest gap is there. So what I was thinking was, if this could sort of like fit into a pocket in a journal, and then have like little sort of smaller pockets dotted about around it. And we'll use vintage photo, I think. And yeah, a couple of small pockets on the inside maybe, and a couple of tags or a couple of little dinky journaling cards. And yeah, I thought that'd look really cool. I think I might use this with the feathers on this plain blue, but as a little pocket, and we'll have a little tag wonky in there, but I'll come back to that one. I think this one with the multi colours, I'll use one of the brighter offcuts. And all I've done is I've got a big plastic bin thing that you all must have with offcuts of all different sizes, and I just rummaged and pulled some of the smaller ones to the top. I don't even know what I've got here, but I pulled some of the smaller bits to the top, because they always seem to get lost at the bottom. And then you forget all about them, and then that's it. It's you just end up using. And the reason I'm still rummaging was because I just saw this at the bottom, and I thought, oh, I definitely want to use that. So yeah, I've pulled some more bits up towards the top, just so that I can see what I've got and what I haven't. And yeah, I thought this. Oh, I might round the corners. I thought these would make lovely little sort of a little book of, tiny book of pocket. Like, so you've just got a couple of pockets here and there. I want that one going that way a bit, I think. and yeah, just some little bits of decoration here and there. What do I fancy? Oh, I might have that straight. Yeah, because I've got some wicked new trim that I think could go across the bottom there. Also, if I'm having that straight, it can be wider. So I'll use that bit I just saw. I thought that was awesome. I love that. And it's got like the yellow and the darker, like it's like a burgundy. Yeah, I really like that. Right, we'll have that instead. So I just want it tiny little bit in from the fold. Flip it up so that we don't draw on the other side. So, how are you all? I hope you're all well. I'm having a lovely week. I've got the kids here. They've gone out, so they've all popped out. They've gone over to see their granddad, who lives just across the green. So they've popped over there for a little while, and I thought I'd rush up here as fast as my little legs can carry me so that I can do some journaling or just making some bits. Just get some of these projects that are being left while I'm doing stuff with the kids. I thought, oh, I'll quickly run upstairs and I'll crack on. Because as much as I love them having here, God, I couldn't say that then, could I? Much as I love having them here, it does get hectic, and it means that a lot of things are just left. I've gone a bit too mental with the ink there, so I'm just smudging it. I'm covered in it, look, already, but I'm just giving it a smudge away. So it's not so in your face. I'm going to add that there. And so, yeah, it's half term. They go back on Monday, I think, to school. But it's been loads of fun. It's just hectic, but lovely. So, yeah, I've got all five grandchildren here. And my two daughters staying as well. Plus my two boys that live with me permanently. So it's an house full, I can tell you that, because even when the girls lived at home before they even had any kids, this ain't a big house, it's a tiny house. And so it was always, if we was all in at the same time, it seems really busy. People go, oh, it's like a madhouse in your house. And it's just us. There's not, it weren't like I would have all like friends or strangers and that in. It was just us. And people used to say it all the time. Oh, ain't it busy around John? Yeah, it is. There's loads of us. So, I've picked this up thinking, oh, that'd be good to go in there. This was a pocket, wasn't it, that I was going to have on the front like that. And I've just cut the bottom off. Oh, I know what I'll do. What we'll do is I'll shave the whole bottom of that off, and then that can be another little pocket on the front of a pocket, if I can get it straight. Yeah, that looks pretty straight. Yep, that'll be another thing. Oh, it started already, isn't it? Here we go. Right, so I've got that nice pocket there, and that's a bit wide. Let's have a look. Something that I haven't got to do too much to. We'll grab a little thing. Right, so I quite like this. So I'm going to stick it on here so that it can be journaled on the back, because although that's plain, it's dark, isn't it? So is there anything in this glue stick? No. I picked up some new ones yesterday, and this was how hectic it was. We went out to the shops, and I picked up a couple of things in the supermarket because my girls wanted to pop in there, and I just said, oh, I'm just popping down the stationery aisle, and grabbed a couple of things, not expensive and that, but like pack of glue sticks. I've got some like a couple of file folders. They was on offer, so I bought two of them, and a couple of other bits just come to under a tenner, right? When I got home and couldn't find none of it, I remembered that, like, we'd gone to the self-service bit where you bleep it through and then put it down. Well, I had a shopping bag with me, but it was a big shopping bag that already had stuff in it. So I wasn't bleeping and putting it into my bag. I was bleeping and just putting it on the bit that's there, the little, like, bit where you're supposed to put your shopping bag. And then I looked down and I was pushing my grandson, and he's just coming up for free. I looked down and he was leaning over squeezing someone else's bananas that was waiting, that was in their basket that they hadn't rung through yet, so he could still reach them. And I was so embarrassed, I quickly was like, no, Jaden, don't touch other people's shopping. And then kind of like I'd finished, got my card back out of the thing, and then just rushed away. And when I got home, I realised that I'd left my shopping where it was, there on the thing. And so I thought, oh, I'll find my receipt and I'll be able to ring them up and then go back tomorrow. Because, like, by the time I realised, it was tea time. And then I looked through all my shopping. And I'd pulled my card out of the machine. I didn't get my receipt. So how can I prove that, oh, yeah, I did pay for them and I left them there, you know? So... And it's ages, well, not ages, but it is quite a way. I can't just pop there and back. And so, yeah, I might go into town tomorrow and then just ask at customer services, did anybody find some shopping that wasn't accounted for? But I don't know whether I'll have a chance because, like I said, I ain't got my receipt. But, yeah. How annoying is that? I couldn't believe it, but it was literally because I was so embarrassed that I just wanted to hurry away as quick as my legs could carry me. And like, my daughter was waiting a little way off and the other one was still ringing through her stuff, and so yeah, I just hurried away and then started saying to my daughter, oh my god, how embarrassing, he was just leaning over squeezing other people's fruit while I was sort of doing my shopping. And the woman, I really apologised. I said, oh, I'm ever so sorry. And like, it was just bananas. You can't, like, they've got their own skin on, haven't they? Like, it's like they come pre-packed because they've got their own skin. And he weren't really, like, he didn't, like, really mutilate it. He just gave it a little squeeze. Well, that's what I see him doing. And I said, oh, I'm ever so sorry. And if someone said that to me, and like I said to him straight away, Jaden, you mustn't touch other people's food or any of their anything at all that's not ours. And then I said to her, again, I'm really sorry. She just gave me the filthiest look and tutted. And I thought, I didn't know what to do with myself. So that's why I just rushed away as quick as I could, because I had been really apologetic about it. But yeah, she didn't care. She just didn't want my grandson anywhere near them bananas, which I do understand. But yeah, it was a bit harsh, really, because I couldn't help it, you know. It wasn't my fault. Literally, I was scanning my own little bits of shopping and I didn't realise that he could reach across like that. But yeah, maybe I should have been trying to look in two directions at once better than I was managing, because yeah, she weren't impressed at all. I felt really awful, and yeah, it made me feel really embarrassed so badly. But what can you do when, like, they're little kids, you know? You always tell them, obviously, not to touch. Like, before we even entered a shop when I was little, my mum always used to say, don't touch anything. But I suppose I'm a bit more laid back because I didn't say that, but I wasn't expecting him to touch anything. But yeah, it was embarrassing, and it cost me a tenner because the stuff, it come to, yeah, something like £9.50, something like that. and I haven't got the stuff. But yeah, never mind. Well, if it would have been earlier, if I'd noticed straight away, even though I didn't have the receipt, if I'd noticed straight away, I could have gone back in there, couldn't I? Or even if I'd noticed as soon as I got home, then one of my sons could have gone up there and done it. But I didn't. It was ages later when I went to listen to something while I was washing up, and the kids was making so much noise, and I was washing up dinner things, and I thought, oh, I'll put my earphones in. And one of the things I'd bought was some new earphones, only cheap ones, they was only £2, but that was one of the things I'd bought, because only one ear in my earphones works at the moment. And yeah, I went to look for my new earphones, and then realised I didn't have none of that stuff from that shop, and that's when I remembered what I'd done, and realised that it could only happen to me, couldn't it? Right, I'm trying to get that in nicely. Yep, that fits okay. I like that then. I want to do a bit of decoration on here. Right, so I bought this lovely trim. It comes unravelled, I think, so because they always put sellotape on the end. So I've just sellotaped around just before. Look, you can see I've got a tiny bit on it. Just before where I wanted to cut, I sellotaped around it before I cut it, so that it don't all unravel and I end up with no trim. So where I've just took the sellotape off and the glue there before I do, one of my lamps has turned around, what's going on? Put some glue there and just kind of make it all stick together so that it don't unravel, because it's a beautiful little trim, isn't it? But I'm gonna have to do the same at that end as well. So I put a bit more glue than I normally would because I want it to hold it together. Right, so we've got that bit there. I really like this though, I think it's lovely. And then I know it might seem a bit excessive, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to put loads of glue on the end before I cut, because look where I've cut there, it's already starting to unravel. So I'm going to kind of smush that in a bit. Where do we get these words from? Smush. I don't know if that's a word or not, but I'm smushing. That's it. Look. Right. And then quickly flip it over, and yeah, that's it, and that'll stay put and not unravel, because I think it's really beautiful. It's quite thick, but I don't care, I really like it, so that's what I'm having. Right, so let's move some of these out of the way. Now for our front, I wanted like a couple of different layers of things. So these are very, very thin. They got sent to me by my lovely friend Amy over at Crafty Cat. And so yeah, I know they're too big, but I'm only gonna take a very small bit. I've also got these that are super thin, which are quite cool because you can colour them any colour you want. But I think I'm not going to use the While You Were outfit. I'm going to go below that because I can use this off on something else. So I think I could do that there. That fits cool because I just want some interest, some little different elements to build up on the front, just for a little bit of interest and decoration. And so, it's the quiet before the storm just right now, because they'll be back soon for dinner, which I'm not even sure what we're having. It's been so hectic, I really don't know. But Nana's surprise, and the surprise is it ain't done yet. So yeah, God knows what we're gonna have. But meal times, it's like feeding time at the zoo. Well, it was last night. I made a really lovely spaghetti bolognese, and I make I have to make two of everything every time I cook, at least two, because I'm vegetarian and my kids aren't. And like the other day, not for lost, I've done like Mexican, like chili and stuff like that, chicken for fajitas for them. But with the chili, I have to make three different lots because I'm a vegetarian and one of my sons don't eat kidney beans, but all the rest love kidney beans. So yeah, I have to make three different chilies that time. And yeah, it's just, it's hectic. And then last night I made that bolognese. I was really pleased with myself. And then the kids didn't like it because I'd put, they could see that I'd put bits of like tomato and mushroom, what have you. I'll just make it the way I make it. It's probably not the proper recipe to be called bolognese, but it's my bolognese, what, how I do it. And yeah, I do put like vegetables in, but what I forgot to do is normally for the children's ones, I take out the sauce before I put the meat in of what I'm doing for the kids and blend it so that it just looks like a tomato-y sauce, that they can't see the actual pieces of tomato and mushroom, and I put a grated carrot in there. And yeah, if I let them see it, oh, that's the worst thing I could do, because not the little ones, they don't really mind so much, but it's Lily, she used to eat loads of vegetables, but she's going through that phase that I think a lot of kids go through of not wanting to eat any vegetables. And yeah, it's a pain, I can tell you that, when you've made it all and it's just being left. And I was saying to her, well, what are you going to have instead? Just eat it. It's the same taste as what you always have, but I haven't blended it. And yeah, she weren't going to be convinced. She was like, I'd rather just have some slices of ham from the fridge. And that's not dinner, is it, you know? And so then I was stressing, thinking, oh, I've got to make another dinner now. But then my daughter said, no, if she's not going to eat it, then if she wants ham, she'll have ham. So I didn't have to make another dinner, but yeah, I felt bad because all she wanted to do was eat ham. But yeah, she did eat quite a lot of it, but still, it's not really a dinner, is it? But yeah, normally my best trick is that I do put loads of vegetables in it and that, more vegetables than meat, but yeah, I like that, yeah. But yeah, I don't let them know because I, blend it beforehand. But yeah, I forgot, so they wasn't tricked at all, and ended up going in the bin. But yeah, never mind, it could be worse, couldn't it? But yeah, then you can imagine with all of us, after dinner, the amount of washing up is ridiculous. But I like it, I won't have a dishwasher, I don't really like them. I like to sit looking out of my kitchen window, and normally what I do is I listen to podcasts or I listen to true crime channels here on YouTube. It fascinates me, things like that. So I normally sit and listen to one of my favourite true crime channels while I'm doing my washing up. And it was so loud though, with the kids playing and what have you, and the telly was on, they were supposed to be watching a film and they was making more noise than the film. My four kids are trying to have conversations with each other. I couldn't hear one single word on the podcast. I could not hear nothing. So that's when I looked for my earphones and realised that they were still at the shop. Never mind. So, hopefully, I'll find some new earphones. Or I have got another pair here somewhere. I'm going to have to dig them out before dinner time, because it's after dinner that I do like to listen to my podcasts or chat other channels. And yeah, I am, because I won't watch something no more. It's got to be something that's just audio, because a few times with other phones, I've been watching something and having it balanced on the windowsill in front of the sink, and I'll just do something stupid and knock it off. I was looking for some side silk, but I can't. I don't think what I want is there. I think it's over here behind me, so I'm just stretching out. Yeah, that's a lovely colour. We'll have a bit of this. Oh! Very accident prone today, I am. I've really, you probably can't tell because of ink, but all this side is bruised. I fell earlier on today. I had a bad fall. And, yeah, I've got scrapes and bruises right up from my ankle up to my hip. And this on, bruised to the underside. This is going to be one of them ones that don't, that don't tear very well. And then it did exactly what I wanted to. A little surprise. But yeah, I burnt myself the other day. I've got an injury on this arm. And then now I fell on this side. It was awful. I laid there for a little while. And then, because it was right outside a row of houses. And I was laying there, just willing someone to look out of their window and then come and help me. And no one did. And I had to try and get up again on my own. And I was really in a lot of pain and really embarrassed. And so part of me didn't want anyone to find me there. And then part of me was thinking, I can't do this on my own. I need help. But yeah, no one saw and no one came. It was just when I was popping out to the supermarket. And yeah, I went on my own so I'd be quicker. I went on my mobility scooter. And yeah, that happened. And so I'm just colouring this whole two in with some Distress Oxide in that lovely blue, because I think that'll bring in that. We'll have that on there. But yeah, how bad's that? I was laying there on the pavement wishing someone would look out and find me. But yeah, they didn't. But it's all cool. I'm all right. I've lived to tell the tale. I'm hurting a little bit. Surprisingly, seems like this is bruised where I sort of tried to put my hand out to stop me. Because, yeah, the whole scooter tipped. There's a path that I have to go down on the way to Tesco's. And the paving slabs and everything are all coming up and all crooked because there's a row of trees there. And I think that the roots of the trees are pushing up the paving stones, and it's really, really wonky. But that's the only way I can get to the supermarket from my house, is to go down that path in front of those houses. And I bumped over the thing, and I went to move the thing to stop, and instead of stopping, I sped up, and then it's my scooter sort of twisted because of going down this, the like, not a ditch, like, but about that much where the paving slabs are uneven, or yeah, about that much, I think. It's quite a big dip. And then obviously you go down, and then the other one's normal height or been pushed up a little bit, so there's quite a gap that you go down and bump in there, get your wheel right in there. And yeah, it made my, so if I don't make a video in the next couple of days, it will mean that the pain has caught up with me, because I'm only hurting from the waist down at the moment. But yeah, who knows what could happen after I've slept, because sometimes that's when it's worse, isn't it? When you've gone to bed and then wake up the next day and you think, oh my gosh, I'm really hurt. So yeah, that might happen, but pray for me that it doesn't, because like I said, the kids are here for the whole holidays. It's only a week they have off, and I just like having as much time with them as possible. And so, yeah, I don't want to spend tomorrow in bed, but I've got a sinking feeling that that may happen, because since I've been back from the shops, it's just getting worse. Right, I got this little trim the other day. I ordered some because where I've been getting my normal pom-pom trim, they've stopped doing it, and I wanted some to send to my friend and for myself. And so then I went online and then I found these ones, which are much better than what I normally have. So I ordered a bit of this for us both, and I think it's going to look really cute along that side. And so, yeah, I might not... I've gone really over the top with that glue there. Yeah, I may or may not post in the next couple of days, depending on the injuries. But yeah, I really didn't need it, because what with that burn on that arm that I did, and I keep knocking that, and it keeps healing over, and then I keep knocking it again, and it's just awful. I had it covered up earlier to try and see if that would help stop me keep catching it. But, yeah, that's just been a pain, really. It's not nothing too terrible. But then, yeah, what I did today. Who does that? Just proper tips. How can you tip a mobility scooter? Well, I know, it wasn't my fault. It is the pavement. The pavement did it. Yeah, it is the that pavement that's there. It shouldn't be like that, you know. But yeah, I should have really slowed right down, shouldn't I? But I think I was had other things on my mind. I was probably going over in my head what shopping I was going to get. Right. Right, I think I like this bit, and I think I was going to do another pocket there, but now I'm thinking I want it at the side. So, let's see, I don't want it too wide, so about there, and where's the top? Top's there. Okay, so we'll just cut that bit to size, and yeah. No, I've got to start being more careful. I'm so accident prone. I think a lot of the time, even though I have got a disability and so I should be trying to go slow, a lot of the time it is like my nervous energy that keeps me going at 200 miles an hour, you know, when I shouldn't be. And yeah, and my brain wanders. I've mentioned before on here, I'm bipolar as well, and my brain leaps around all over the place. Do you know what I'm looking for? My corner rounder. And I had it, didn't I? What have I done with it now? Who knows? Oh, here it is. Sorry. Oh, I dropped it on the floor. And yeah, my brain wanders, especially when I'm doing something really mundane that I do quite often, like a few times a week, which is riding up that, my light went off, riding up that little path past those houses behind mine on my way to the shops. I do that a lot, especially on my scooter. If I'm on my scooter, that's the way I go. And I suppose because I do it so often, my brain just stopped paying attention, which is the worst thing you can do, isn't it, really? Especially if you're in control of a little vehicle. Although, albeit it's really slow, it goes at 4 miles an hour. Most people walk quicker than that. People take me over when I'm going along, because I do only go slow. 4 miles an hour is nothing, is it? And my scooter's old now. I don't even think it does 4 miles an hour anymore. I'd be lucky if it does two and a half. but yeah, still too fast to fall off and it not hurt. But yeah, it's one of them things, isn't it? The kids will laugh when they can't get back because, yeah, they're over at their granddad's. And yeah, my girls are over there as well. And so I think, yeah, my son just come home and he's, because I said that's where they all was, he said, oh, he'll pop over there, because it's literally, it's so close to us, it's nearer than it is for me to get to the supermarket. I sort of have to go past these to get to there. And yeah, so I haven't really told anyone yet of my little drama, what happened to me today. But, yeah, they'll laugh. It won't, they'll think it's funny. I won't get a lot of sympathy here. Not that I want any sympathy. I really don't. It makes me laugh that they'll laugh, you know. I'd rather that than them, like, feeling all worried or sorry for me or anything. It's funny, isn't it? I was laying there flailing about, waiting for someone to come out of their house and rescue me, and they didn't. And so, yeah, I think my kids, that's going to be their favourite thing tonight, better than their dinner, which I still ain't cooked. And I think no one else is cooking tonight. I think because I'm in, they're thinking, oh, Mum will be doing it while we're out, because I'm in and they ain't. But, my knee and my hip really hurt. I won't be able to be being walking around the kitchen. That's why I've come up here, because I can just sit. And I've only got to move my arms. And although this one is starting to hurt a bit now, whereas it wasn't at all earlier. And so, yeah, I'm finding this a lot easier. I definitely ain't going to be trying to cook all different dinners tonight, I don't think. They'll have to find something easy to cook themselves and cook some for Mama. Oh dear. It could be worse, couldn't it? And yeah, I know that they're just going to take the mick out of me all night now. And Jamie, as soon as I tell him, he'll be like, oh my lord, you shouldn't go out on your own. He worries. Because he says, how do you do these things? How do you manage to hurt yourself or do these stupid things? And so, yeah, he worries because, like yesterday, my brain was not on picking up my shopping. It was, as soon as my grandson was doing that, my brain leapt from sorting the shopping out to, oh, I've got to sort, like, I've got to apologise and sort this out, and do you know what I mean? Whereas if I would have been more chilled about it, I probably wouldn't have forgotten my stuff, would I? But, never mind. But this is going to go in here. Just that back in there. So I'm just going to have a couple of little things on show, on like that, and I'm going to have some fabric going down the side there. This is quite nice and goes with the colour quite well, so I think I'm going to have a bit of that. I've got to cut it shorter and thinner, not too much though, because I want to fray it a bit. That's it, I like that. Looks really pretty when it's frayed and that, I think. And I think I'm going to layer that up with a couple of other pieces. Do I want a bit of that? I'm not sure. Let's see. Sorry, I went really silent there. Oh, and I've just cut that all wrong. It's it's not going well today. Right, I found this bit. It's really thick, right? But I really like it. So, I think that will look really nice. So, I nearly put the glue on top of the thing then, on top of the fabric instead of under it. What a donut, ain't I? Right. I want that just on top like that. I really, really like that. And it's thick, but that's okay. Because it could sort of be like, instead of a tab that I'd use to put it in and out. And then just a little bit of ink around this. And that's got to go down here, and that can go in that pocket. Was going to make another little tag as well for in here with that one, and I was going to do something else on the front, wasn't I? But yeah, so that's a nice journaling card, I like that. And once that's slid in there, once that's in there, then that's like that. So we've got our little booklet sort of thing made out of an index card. Journaling tag there. A little journaling card there and a tag here. And yeah, I might do another little tag. I don't think I'm going to do the other, what's it? Because, yeah, I'm starting to hurt a bit now, so you can tell, can't you, because my brain starts going all funny, like I can't really think of more than one thing at once. Oh, that's what I was going to do. I found these little things that I had. I was going to use one of these, but I suppose that it could go like that. Oh, let's see, what else have we got? Yeah, I think I might use this one, just that one, and have it in there. I can leave the back blank. I'll just ink around the edge. Yeah, I was looking for something else last night, and I found these, and thought, I forgot I even bought them. I'm a nightmare for that as well. But, right, let's try again. No, I don't want that colour anyway. Let's see. Have we got anything? Would that be long enough? No. Oh, this yellowy colour. I like that. Oh, and but I'll try and rip it. Oh, I don't think I'm going to be able to tear anything. Ah, no, I can't. Right. Oh, I'll just have to cut it. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to tear this one. But that's no dramas. I don't know if it'll go through. It might be too thick. I might have to cut it again. Because I don't want to tear the cardboard. I could put an eyelet in, couldn't I? As well. Oh, will it do it? Oh, yeah, it did tear a little bit. And I am gonna put an eyelet in so that I don't have to feel nervous about pulling it as tight as I want it. Because without that reinforcing, it's likely to go peak time, isn't it? So let's get this in here. Oh, and I know we haven't done a white lot, but I feel quite worn out now, but I've really enjoyed coming up and just having the peace and quiet and having a little natter with you guys, because for me that's what it's all about. It just, I love the interaction I have with you all, and I'm so grateful. And but just before I end, because I'm going to leave this here and I'll do the other one another time, yeah, just before I finish, if anyone is interested, if they've seen my previous videos and is interested in our junk journaling holiday by the sea, in my last video that I put up of me and Lily craft with me and Lily doing a collage pocket, all the details are under there. Under this one, I'll leave Maggie's email address if you've got any questions, and I'll also leave the link. We've got a Facebook group. Not that I really know how to do Facebook. Oh, and I just want to say, if anyone sent me a message on Facebook and I haven't replied, that's because I don't know how to get into the messagey bit. Every time I go to click on what the message is, it's saying I've got two messages, and when I click on it, it takes me completely off of Facebook, and I don't know what I'm doing. So, I ain't very good at social medias, but Maggie is. And we've got this Facebook group that I do manage to get in there, and it's called Collective Junk Journalers, or Junk Journal, no, Collective Junk Journaling. Yeah, Collective Junk Journaling, that's it. I think it's it. But I'll leave the link below anyway. So if you're interested or just curious about what's what, I'll leave the links and you can go from there. And yeah, I'll probably talk a bit more about it next time. This time I've been moaning and I'm about falling over and God knows what else. Yeah, losing my shopping. But yeah, I like what we made and that. So I hope you've had fun crafting along with me. Thank you ever so much for joining me. I really do appreciate all of you. And I'll be back with something else very soon. Bye-bye. Bye.